السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. جزاكم الله خيرا. Thank you all for attending this program today. We are grateful for your support, and we are grateful for all those who contributed to organizing this event, and for all those who helped pack the food. As you know, inshallah, we will be serving food to go after the program. However, if you would like to stay in the masjid, inshallah, and have dinner here with your families after Salat al-Maghrib, you're more than welcome to do so, inshallah. And we will start today's program with just a brief opening and reflection from the grandfather of Dawood. And he would just like to share a bit about his experience and Dawood's sort of upbringing with the Qur'an. And then afterwards, Dawood will recite a little bit for us, inshallah. And of course, alhamdulillah, Dawood is the one we are honoring here today because he has, alhamdulillah, successfully memorized the Qur'an with our beloved Sheikh Khalid. And then afterwards, we will allow Sheikh Uthman to speak a little bit on the virtues of the Qur'an. And Sheikh Khalid will also share a little bit. And then I will recite. And after we conclude with dua for, we'll do the khatma dua as well as dua for Dr. Irfan, Allah yarhamu. And then we will conclude the program. But once again, jazakumullah khairan, inshallah, without further ado, I'd just like the grandfather Dawood.
Alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen. Wassalatu wassalamu ala Rasulil Alameen. Dear guests, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. It is a great blessing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that he in his infinite mercy gave all of us an opportunity to come here from far and near to participate in this function. It is a happy occasion, joyous occasion, solemn occasion. And the man of the hour is my grandson Dawood, who has memorized the Quran, alhamdulillah. So Dawood happens to be the fifth grandchild who has memorized the Quran in the family. So the first person who memorized was my third daughter. What is your name? What is it? Look at it. I'm forgetting the name. Atiya. Look at this. My memory. Atiya, mashallah, she is known to spring many surprises. She gave a surprise when she was born. When she was born in Oxford, Nebraska. And in that hospital, nobody has seen a newborn baby with black hair. Head full of black shiny hair. So she made the news at the time of her birth. And the news spread from the hospital to the town of about 2,000 people. The mayor of the city, the chief of the police, and several other people started coming to the hospital to see the baby with the head full of black shiny hair. I said, if the hospital had put some entry fee, they would have made some money. Well, alhamdulillah, that was the first surprise my third daughter, Atiya, gave it. And the second surprise was when she graduated from high school, and alhamdulillah, she's a very intelligent girl. She scored 32 out of 36 on the ACT, and she was given admission here in the electrical department here, University of Illinois, Champaign-Urbana. So we were very happy. She got admission. Now she has to go to college. In about 2 weeks, she has to start. She comes home and she says, I said, are you ready to go to the college? No, I have to do HIFS. I'm like, what are you talking? You got the admission. You have to go to the college in 2 weeks. And you are saying you want to do HIFS? How is it possible? He said, no, I have to. I thought it is a fleeting thought that came to her mind, it will disappear. It didn't. She persisted. She demanded that I need to do HIFS. There was no office available to supervise her. So I had to send her to Bangalore, India, to stay in the house of my wife's brother, Mama. And there was one Maulana who happened to be the friend of me and my elder brother. He came to the house in Bangalore every day and did this monumental task of making her memorize the Quran. So she did finished her memorization in a year and a half, came back, and then went to University of here, Champaign, finished her electrical engineering. So the forerunner, the trailblazer, you know, for starting this HIFS is my third daughter, Atiya Ismail, and alhamdulillah, we have her husband, Umar, and his parents also are sitting here, who came all the way from Toledo, Ohio. So that was the first one who started this. Then my first daughter, Aisha, she has three children. All the three of them are Hufaz. And they did it in St. Louis, and Maulana Haroon was the main person to make them memorize. Then my second daughter, Asma, who lives in Dallas, Texas, and his son, Mansoor, my grandson, also became the Hafiz. So we have five grandchildren who are Hufaz, one daughter, Hafiza. We have also one imported one too. My grandson, Farhan Sharif, got married to a Hafiza last year, and the bride happens to be a Hafiza and a Halima. So alhamdulillah, it is a great blessing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I thought it is not my effort. My father prayed for that. My father wanted that all his children should be there, should memorize Quran and should take a leading part in the propagation of the religion. His prayers were answered. So may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give him Jannat al-Firdaus. So dear brothers and sisters, and it is a great occasion, as I said, solemn occasion, happy occasion that Dawood has completed. I never believed it. I thought this guy is running around all the time, you know, and Sheikh Khalid. And I said, what is this remote system? I said, oh, Sheikh Khalid, on the phone. Dawood on the phone. What is Dawood doing? Jumping from one bed to another, running, staying there, reciting one ayah, and then jumping. I said, what kind of students are supposed to sit in the front of the Hafiz and do it? But this is new system. Alhamdulillah, he did it in this new method, mercurial in temper, but he did it. So, as I said, people have come from far and near to participate in this function. So, alhamdulillah, we have brother, Aisha and Farid, they are running. Let me tell you this one. Aisha and Farid, my son-in-law and first daughter, they run a program in St. Louis. Nearly 100 students have completed their memorization. 100 have become Hufaz. And my daughter and they run a parallel program. That means they don't want the children to neglect the regular subjects like English, you know, science and maths. So at home, they tutor the students. So when the time comes for them to get admission into the high school, they are ready. So they have, for 10 years, they have built a reputation. And alhamdulillah, they have, wherever, after the completing their HIFS, after completing these subjects, when they go to seek admission in the high school, they are welcome. So you should start a program similar to that in this place also, inshallah. So, so alhamdulillah, this is one thing that said take home for the people of Champaign. And I said people have come from far and near. The first delegation is from St. Louis, Aisha, Farid, my son, son-in-law, and daughter. And then we have Farhan Sharif, mashallah, he completed his Alim course in South Africa, and now he is a teacher in Darussalam in Lombard, Illinois. And then we have my second daughter, Asma, and Abdul Khadar and family. They drove all the way from Dallas whole night and they are here to participate in function. In fact, my daughter runs a Montessori school, a school for excellence. Alhamdulillah, it is running on a very smooth basis, and students are waiting. The building is not there, but the students are waiting for admission into that school in Dallas, Texas. And we have my another grandson, Mansoor, Alhamdulillah, who is a Hafiz. He led the Taraweeh in Dallas. That's Alhamdulillah, he has kept up the practice. So we have also from, who else is, I'm leaving out. Oh, from my relative, Rehan and his family, who came all the way from San Jose to participate in this function. So if I leave any other person, you know, remind me. So all this was possible because of the dedication of the parents of Dr. Weiss and his family, and because the parents are the first step to mold the minds of the children, their children, to take up this in seemingly impossible task of memorizing the Quran. 6,666 verses to memorize. I tried to memorize Surah Kahf, it took me 4 months, still I falter. So it is a great blessing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, His mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that He gave these young minds, you know, the power to grasp and to remember it. May Allah give him the determination to pursue this. May not only just memorize it, but try to understand the meaning of it also. So, alhamdulillah. So with that, I think I am done. And I thank you, all of you, for coming here and participating in this mission. Make dua for them that he remains steadfast in learning more and more about our Quran and understanding. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. I cannot leave this mic without praising the monumental patience. I don't know how much patience he has. Jablu Sabr, mountain of patience. You know, these children run around. They take, you know, one second here, second minute there, and he waits on the phone. He calls Dawood. Okay, 5 minutes gone. Suleiman, another 5 minutes gone. Jumping. So much patience, may Allah give him more patience to control this mercurial young man. So I have to thank our Sheikh Imam, you know, for guiding these people. So my time is up. Okay, if my time is up.
Jazakallah khairah, thank you so much for that beautiful speech, and we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept from all of your efforts and your commitment to ensuring that your children and your grandchildren become those who preserve the Quran within their hearts. Allah barak feek. And now we will begin with we'll allow Sheikh Khaled to recite a little bit, and then he will also express and share a little bit, a small statement of gratitude towards those who have contributed greatly to Dawood's memorization and also this community and the masjid here in general. Without further ado, Sheikh Khaled will recite now.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم قبل أن أبدأ سأتكلم بالعربية والشيخ زين إن شاء الله سيترجم انتظر أشكر الله أولا ثم أشكر الدكتور ويس المنصوري والأخت الفاضلة عفيفة إسماعيل أسأل الله عز وجل أن يغفر لهم وأن يرحمهم فكم تحملوا وكم صبروا.
Okay. So he would like to first of all to thank Dr. Weiss and Sister Afifa, his wife, and he would ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive them, and he's saying how patient are they and how much can they tolerate.
Secondly,
I'd like to
العم محمد الهيتي.
عمر.
جزاه الله خيرا صاحب برنامج تحفيظ القرآن في المسجد.
He is the one who is. He'd like to thank عمر الهيتي because he is the one who initiated the تحفيظ program and the one that the pornography encouraging people to memorize the Quran here in the masjid.
وأشكر أيضا مجلس إدارة المسجد أسأل الله أن يغفر لهم أجمعين وأن يهديهم إلى الصواب.
And he'd like to express his gratitude to the council and the committee at the masjid here and he asks Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive them all and to make them and to grant mercy.
ولا أنسى.
أن
أشكر الأخ الفاضل عماد الرحمن والدكتور عز الرحمن أسأل الله أن يغفر لهم وأن يرحمهم.
آمين. He does not forget that he must thank you know, a brother عماد الرحمن and express gratitude for all he's done. He asks Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive him.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. وبالحق أنزلناه وبالحق نزل وما أرسلناك إلا مبشرا ونذيرا وقرآنا فرقناه لتقرأه على الناس على مكث وبالحق أنزلناه وبالحق نزل وما أرسلناك إلا مبشرا ونذيرا وقرآنا فرقناه لتقرأه على الناس على مكث ونزلناه تنزيلا قل آمنوا به أو لا تؤمنوا قل آمنوا به أو لا تؤمنوا إن الذين أوتوا العلم من قبله إذا يتلى عليهم يخرون للأذقان سجدا ويقولون سبحان ربنا إن كان وعد ربنا لمفعولا صدق الله العظيم
تكبير Okay, Sheikh Uthman will now share a little bit in regards to the virtue of the Quran and just more in regards to the reverence we're supposed to have for the Quran and the Book of Allah as Muslims. So without further ado, Sheikh.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh. Alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen wa salatu wa salamu ala sayyidi al-musaleen wa ala alihi wa ashabihi wa sallim tasliman kathira. اللهم علمنا ما ينفعنا وانفعنا بما علمتنا واجعل العلم حجة لنا لا حجة علينا آمين. So we gather here for a blessed event. This is a blessed event because first it's happening on a Friday between Asr and Maghrib. And this time is, it is said that the hour in which Allah will not reject any dua that is made, it is between Asr and Maghrib. So this is a blessed gathering. And second, we are also here to witness the khatam of the Quran, the completion of the Quran from our young brother here, Dawood. That's also a blessed event in which mercy from Allah descends. And third, we all know the hadith in which the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that never a group of people will gather in the house, in the house of the houses of Allah, except the angels will cover them and mercy and tranquility will descend upon them. So we gather here three blessings, and that's important. So before we end the program, make sure that you dedicate some of your dua, the most precious dua, the dearest thing that you have to ask Allah, and ask before right at before the end of this program. Quran, learning Quran is very important. All of us, we know that. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said in the hadith, "Inna lillahi ahlina." Allah has his own people among the believers. And the Sahaba were wondering, who are those people of Allah? Who are those people? So they asked the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, who are those people? He said, the people of Allah are those who carry the Quran, those who recite the Quran and carry it in their memory. And in another hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, خَيْرُكُمْ مَنْ تَعَلَّمَ الْقُرْآنَ وَعَلَّمَهُ. The best of you, the best of the believers is a person who learned the Quran and the person who teaches the Quran. So this means that as a believer, you have to be one of these two. If you're not one of these two, you have to question yourself and quickly make a program to be one of these two, either learning Quran or teaching Quran. Right? And there's no time limit for learning Quran. All of us need to learn, and we can learn. We have to make a program. We have to arrange our schedule accordingly. And Sheikh Khalid taught me something yesterday and today, very interesting. He said that Dr. Irfan, may Allah have mercy on him, was reciting every week. He was memorizing, and he finished Surah Amma, or Juz Amma, in memorization. And also he recited the whole Quran from Al-Fatiha to An-Nas with him. So that's one of the way we learn Quran. You memorize some of the Quran. That's not given to all of us. And we have sometimes difficulties in memorizing, but have some memorization of the Quran. The other thing, that have some reading of the Quran. Sit with someone, Sheikh Khalid is here, who can check your recitation and try to recite the Quran cover to cover at least one time in front of a sheikh, because this is how Quran is transmitted. Jibreel came, he transmitted the Quran to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The Prophet did not learn Quran by himself. He has to listen to Jibreel. He has to listen to Jibreel. The Sahaba has to listen to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The Tabi'in listen to the Sahaba, and the Tabi'in listen to the Tabi'in till the Quran came to us. And most of those who recite the Quran, they will have the chain of transmitters to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So let us be one of these two, learning Quran or teaching Quran. And barakallahu feekum, jazakumullahu khairan kaseera. Assalamu alaikum.
Jazakumullahu khairan, Sheikh Uthman. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept from all of the work that you put into this community, and we truly appreciate having you as our imam and our role model and our guide and instructor here. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept from all of your righteous actions as well. Jazakumullahu khairan. And now, inshallah, I will briefly recite and then also share a little bit of my experience, because alhamdulillah, I've also recently memorized the Quran with Sheikh Khalid. I was able to, as many of you were there witnessing during the month of Ramadan, I did my khatma after before Salat al-Tarawih. And alhamdulillah, there's a lot I would like to say in regards to the gratitude I feel and I would like to express to Sheikh and all of you in this community. But I will start with just, of course, the best of speech, which is the speech of Allah.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم إن هذا القرآن يهدي للتي هي أقوم ويبشر المؤمنين الذين يعملون الصالحات أن لهم أجرا كبيرا وأن الذين لا يؤمنون بالآخرة أعتدنا لهم عذابا أليما ويدعو الإنسان بالشر دعاءه بالخير وكان الإنسان عجولا وجعلنا الليل والنهار آيتين فمحونا آية الليل وجعلنا آية النهار مبصرة وجعلنا آية النهار مبصرة لتبتغوا فضلا من ربكم ولتعلموا عدد السنين والحساب وكل شيء فصلناه تفصيلا وكل إنسان ألزمناه طائره في عنقه ونخرج له يوم القيامة كتابا يلقاه منشورا اقرأ كتابك اقرأ كتابك كفى بنفسك اليوم عليك حسيبا من اهتدى فإنما يهتدي لنفسه ومن ضل فإنما يضل عليها ولا تزر وازرة وزر أخرى وما كنا معذبين حتى حتى نبعث رسولا صدق الله العظيم.
بسم الله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا. Once again, I'd just like to thank you all for attending and being with us here today to honor this wonderful moment for my dear brother Dawood Mansouri. And Alhamdulillah, I'm so glad that both of us have had the tremendous privilege of studying under the great, Alhamdulillah, the blessing for our community, Sheikh Khalid Al-Roubi. Alhamdulillah, his tutelage and his instruction has been something that is remarkable and unique, and I truly believe that he is, there's no other teacher like him in the world, mashallah, alhamdulillah. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless him and his family. And I thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, of course, for honoring us and allowing us and facilitating for us to memorize the Quran. This is something that, alhamdulillah, this is a special privilege and a special blessing that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bestows upon his ibad. And it's not a light matter whatsoever, and it requires a tremendous amount of discipline and sacrifice and effort and concertation. And for that, I'm truly, alhamdulillah, grateful that Allah has given us this opportunity and facilitated this achievement for us. And I would also, though my parents are not here today, I'd like to, ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive them and to reward them for all they've done to help me and aid me in my studies and my memorization of the Quran. And inshallah, I can't wait, inshallah, on Yawm al-Qiyamah, inshallah, when I get to Ya Rabbi, inshallah, I place the crown on their forehead, because this is the honor that the Hafiz of the Quran has on the Day of Judgment. As Shaykh Khalid, as the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said in an authentic hadith, that this is the Hafiz of the Quran on the Day of Judgment will crown both of his parents for the reward that he has and for the achievement that he's accomplished in this dunya. And subhanAllah, there's a lot I could say and not so much time to do so, but once again, I'd like to just thank Shaykh Khalid and his family. They've done so much for me, more than I could have ever imagined. And subhanAllah, bisaraha, ma darsh ashkur liku kifaya, Shaykhna Allah, mutashakrawi, liku wa asaw rabbana yubarik fiku wa yuthi khair gaza. وسبحان الله أنا بطلب منك من حضرتك إني العفو ودعائك كمان عشان أنا أعرف أنا تعبتك يا سيدي فسامحني. وإني أتألي I'm just saying I apologize to for all the effort and the hard work I put Sheikh Khalid through, in my time with him. And alhamdulillah, he's really a remarkable teacher, I feel like sometimes I take too much انا بستغل لك بعض الاحيان يعني ان كان حبيبك عسل ما تلحسوش كله صح سو so I'd just like to continue to encourage everyone else in this community to take advantage of this amazing blessing that we have here. Sheikh Khalid and his family, and they're always willing to help whoever is interested in memorizing the Quran, whoever is interested in studying the Quran. They're more than glad to assist anyone doing so. And with that being said, inshallah, I will now pass the microphone off to Dawood, and he will recite his khatma right now, and we will conclude afterwards with a brief dua, inshallah. Jazakallah khair.
Before he recites, it is a great blessing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that Dawood is reciting the Quran in the presence of his grandfather and the whole family. May I request the grandfather, Dr. Yusuf Bukhari and Mansouri, and Shahid Mansouri and his family to raise your hand to identify themselves that the grandparents are here. Inshallah.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. آمن الرسول بما أنزل إليه من ربه والمؤمنون كل آمن بالله وملائكته وملائكته وكتبه ورسله لا نفرق بين أحد من رسله وقالوا سمعنا وأطعنا غفرانك ربنا وإليك المصير لا يكلف الله نفسا إلا وسعها لها ما كسبت وعليها ما اكتسبت ربنا لا تؤاخذنا إن نسينا أو أخطأنا ربنا ولا تحمل علينا إصرا كما حملته على الذين من قبلنا ربنا ولا تحملنا ما لا طاقة لنا به واعف عنا واغفر لنا وارحمنا أنت مولانا فانصرنا على القوم الكافرين بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم قل هو الله أحد الله الصمد لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم قل أعوذ برب الفلق من شر ما خلق ومن شر غاسق إذا وقب ومن شر النفاثات في العقد ومن شر حاسد إذا حسد بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم قل أعوذ برب الناس ملك الناس إله الناس من شر الوسواس الخناس الذي يوسوس في صدور الناس من الجنة والناس بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين
اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد في الأولين صلي على سيدنا محمد في الآخرين صلي على سيدنا محمد في الملأ الأعلى إلى يوم الدين اللهم إنا حضرنا ختم كتابك اللهم تقبل منا أجمعين اللهم تقبل منا أجمعين اللهم تقبل منا أجمعين اللهم لك الحمد على ختم كتابك اللهم لك الحمد على ختم كتابك ولك الشكر على ختم كتابك اللهم اجعلنا من أهل القرآن ارزقنا أدب القرآن وشفاعة القرآن اللهم ارزقنا شفاعة القرآن اللهم ارزقنا أدب القرآن اللهم اجعل القرآن لنا في الدنيا قرينا وفي القبر مؤنسا وعلى الصراط نورا وإلى الخيرات كلها دليلا وإماما اللهم ألبسنا به الحلل وأسكننا به الظلل واكتب لنا فيه أجورا اللهم اجعل القرآن قائدنا إلى رضوانك والجنة ولا تجعله سائقنا إلى سخطك والنار اللهم اغفر لنا أجمعين اللهم تقبل منا أجمعين اللهم بارك لنا في ابننا داود وبارك لنا في ابننا زين اللهم اغفر لهما واغفر لآبائهم وأمهاتهم اللهم اغفر لآبائهم وأمهاتهم يا رب العالمين اللهم اجزهم خير الجزاء اللهم اجزهم خير الجزاء على تحفيظ أبنائهم القرآن اللهم ارزق أبناءنا حفظ القرآن اللهم ارزق أبناءنا هداية القرآن اللهم إنا نسألك الجنة وما قرب إليها من قول أو عمل ونعوذ بك من النار وما قرب إليها من قول أو عمل لا إله إلا أنت سبحانك إنا كنا من الظالمين اللهم من كان منا مريضا فاشف مرضه ومن كان منا مديونا فاقض دينه ومن كان منا مهموما فاذهب همه ومن كان منا مكروبا فاذهب كربه اللهم انصر إخواننا المجاهدين في كل مكان، اللهم انصر إخواننا المجاهدين في غزة، اللهم انصر إخواننا المجاهدين في فلسطين، اللهم انصرهم نصرا عزيزا مؤزرا يا رب العالمين. اللهم اخذل من خذلهم وانصر من نصرهم. اللهم إنا نبرأ بحولنا وقوتنا إلى حولك وقوتك يا قوي يا متين. اللهم اغفر للدكتور عرفان، اللهم اغفر له وارحمه وعافه واعف عنه وأكرم نزله ووسع مدخله ونقيه من خطاياه بالثلج والماء والبرد. اللهم ارحمنا إذا صرنا إلى ما صار إليه. اللهم ارحم موتانا موتى المسلمين، اللهم ارحم موتانا موتى المسلمين، واشف مرضانا مرضى المسلمين، وارفع الهم والغم والكرب والبلاء عنا وعن أمة محمد أجمعين. اللهم ارزق بناتنا وشبابنا العفة يا رب العالمين. اللهم إنا نعوذ بك من أن نشرك بك شيئا نعلمه، ونستغفرك لما لا نعلمه. اللهم أنت أعلم بحوائجنا فاقضها، وأنت أعلم بعيوبنا فاسترها. اللهم استرنا في الدنيا والآخرة يا رب العالمين. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. اللهم إنك عفو تحب العفو فاعف عنا. اللهم عافنا من بلاء الدنيا والآخرة يا رب العالمين. هذا الدعاء ومنك الإجابة، وهذا الجهد عليك التكلان، ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم، وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم.
اللهم لك الحمد كله ولك الشكر كله، وإليك يعود الأمر كله، علانيته وسره، أهل أنت أن تشكر، أهل أنت أن تحمد. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم، وبارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم في العالم إنك حميد مجيد. اللهم إنا نسألك بأنك أنت الله لا إله إلا أنت المنان بديع السماوات والأرض، يا ذا الجلال والإكرام، يا حي يا قيوم. Oh Allah, we ask you by virtue of the fact that all praise is due to you. There is no God but you. You are the Mannan, the generous provider. You are the Badi', the originator of the heavens and the earth. O Lord of majesty and splendor, O living one, O eternal. Allahumma inna nas'aluka bi'annana nashhad بِأَنَّا نَشْهَدُ أَنَّكَ أَنْتَ اللَّهُ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا أَنْتَ الْأَحَدُ الصَّمَدُ الَّذِي لَمْ يَلِدْ وَلَمْ يُولَدْ وَلَمْ يَكُنْ لَهُ كُفُوًا أَحَدٌ. Oh Allah, we ask you by virtue of the fact that we all bear witness that there's no God but you. You are the one, the absolute, who has not begotten and has not been begotten, and to whom none is equal. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. O Lord, give us in this world that which is good, and the hereafter that which is good, and save us from the torment of hellfire. ربنا لا تزغ قلوبنا بعد إذ هديتنا وهب لنا من لدنك رحمة إنك أنت الوهاب. O Lord, let not our hearts deviate from the truth after you. After you have guided us and granted us mercy from you, truly you are the bestower. ربنا آمنا بما أنزلت واتبعنا الرسول فاكتبنا مع الشاهدين. O Allah, we believe in what you have sent down and we follow the messenger, so write us down among those who bear witness. ربنا إننا سمعنا مناديا ينادي للإيمان أن آمنوا بربكم فآمنا. ربنا فاغفر لنا ذنوبنا وكفر عنا سيئاتنا وتوفنا مع الأبرار. ربنا وآتنا ما وعدتنا على رسلك ولا تخزنا يوم القيامة إنك لا تخلف الميعاد. O Allah, we have heard the call of the one calling us to faith. Believe in your Lord and we have believed. O Allah, forgive us our sins. Remit from us our evil deeds and take to your soul, to yourself our souls in the company of the righteous. O Allah, grant us what you promised unto us through the messengers and save us from disgrace of the disgrace of the day of judgment. for you never break your promise. ربنا ظلمنا أنفسنا وإن لم تغفر لنا وترحمنا لنكونن من الخاسرين. Oh Lord, we have wronged our own selves. If you forgive us not and bestow not upon us your mercy, we will certainly be lost. ربنا أفرغ علينا صبرا معاشنا وأصلح لنا آخرتنا التي فيها معادنا واجعل الحياة زيادة لنا في كل خير واجعل الموت راحة لنا من كل شر. O Allah, set right for us our adherence to Islam, for it is the protection of our affairs. Set right for us our lives in this world, for it is where our currently life is. Set right for us our lives in the hereafter, for it is the result to which we must return. Make life for us a source of increase in all type of goodness, and make death for us comfort from every type of hardship and evil. اللهم إنا نعوذ بك من الهم والحزن والعجز والكسل والجبن والبخل وضلع الدين وغلبة الرجال ونعوذ بك من فتنة المحيا والممات. O Allah, we seek refuge in you from worry, from grief, from incapacity and laziness, from cowardice and miserliness, from being heavily in debt, and from being overpowered by men. And we seek your protection against the torment of the grave and the trials of this life. اللهم إنا نعوذ بك من زوال نعمتك وتحول عافيتك وفجعة نقمتك وجميع سخطك. O Allah, we seek refuge in you against the decline of your favors, the passing of your safety, and the suddenness of your punishment and all that which displeases you. اللهم إنا نعوذ بك من الجوع فإنه بئس inclination toward what is haram. O Allah, grant us enough of your grace so that we may not depend on any other person beside you. اللهم فارج الهم كاشف الغم مجيب دعوة المضطرين رحمن الدنيا والآخرة ورحيمهما. نسألك أن ترحمنا وتنصر المسلمين المستضعفين في كل مكان. اللهم انصر المسلمين المستضعفين في غزة. اللهم انصر المسلمين المستضعفين في فلسطين. اللهم اجعل ثأرهم على من ظلمهم وانصرهم على من عاداهم وثبت أقدامهم وزلزل الأرض تحت أقدام أعدائهم. لا إله إلا أنت سبحانك إنا كنا من الظالمين. O Allah, restore the health of all those who are suffering from any type of illness, such as kidney disease and heart diseases, cancer, mental illness, depression, and anxiety. O Allah, send your healing to all those who desperately need good health, and those who desperately need financial stability and relief from death. We seek refuge in your might and power from the evil of what we and all and they all experience and try to avert. O Lord of mankind, remover of harm, heal us all, for you are the healer. There is no healer but you. Heal us with a remedy which leaves no disease behind. Please forgive all the Muslims of the Ummah. Make their trials easy on them, those who are with us and those who are absent. Muhammadin wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallim tasliman kathira. Amen.
Okay, with that being said, inshallah, we will now conclude the program. But just briefly, we'd like a very special guest to recite for us today. This is Sheikh Aziz Al-Rubi, inshallah. He's just going to recite, inshallah. Inshallah, he will be a hafiz one day as well. Fadla Aziz.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. إنا أعطيناك الكوثر فصل لربك وانحر.
أيوة
إن شانئك. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. قل هو الله أحد.
With that, inshallah, we now conclude. JazakAllahu khairan. Assalamu alaikum.